you aren't in Edinburgh that often. I can eat at the Tower any time. An excited voice calls out our names. It's Shona. The first thing I notice about her is that she looks tanned and healthy. She's spent the last 5 years in Australia. Her short, spiky hair is white, without a hint of grey. It suits her. "You look stunning," Elspeth says, kissing the air around Shona's cheeks. "You don't look so bad yourself," Shona says, hugging Elspeth, but not too closely. She winks at me over Elspeth's shoulder. Elspeth picks up on Shona's Australian twang.
"Struth, Shona, you've turned into a right Aussie. We're going to have to call you Sheila from now on."
Her accent is execrable. Shona ignores her and holds her arms out to me. "How long has it been?" she asks. I've done the calculation in advance, and I suspect Shona has too. "Far too long," I say, smiling. I imagine I can taste the salt sea air of St Andrews in Shona's hair. When it comes to making associations with people, my senses seem to go into overload. With Elspeth, it's the scent of musk from the cheap perfume she wore before she began her professional life and could afford the more expensive brands. With Lucy, it would be the sticky sweet aroma of patchouli from the joss sticks she burnt to mask the smell when she was smoking dope. With Moira, it would probably be the taste of malt whiskey, which she introduced me to one evening at a pub on the Scores. And Doug, the velvety feel of his shorn hair after an unforgiving haircut.
"This is where we're eating?"
Shona asks, nodding at the entrance to the witchery. She turns to me with a twinkle,